can't climb out. Can you think of some way to help me? I'm so cold and scared. Thank you so much for saving me. I'm Fiora. See that mountain far away? That's the volcano Mount Bashar in the Darklands. There's a fortress there with statues. I was playing there as usual, but today something really scary happened. One of the statues came to life. I got so scared that I ran away without looking back and hid in this well. And who are you? You're just so pretty. What? From another world? Oh, great! Welcome to the Lost Lands. If you want to learn more about our world, talk to my great-grandpa. He's the elder of the Druid Guild. It's not far from here in the forest. The village gates are locked, of course, to keep strangers out, but my great-grandpa gave me this password. Oh, this is my picture! I drew my favorite doll. Her name is Blossom, but I dropped her into the well when I hid from that winged demon. The picture's all I have left now.
Believe my eyes. It's you. Remember me, Maren? It just so happens that we need your help again. Ugh, where to start? This morning, a harpy attacked us. It has been petrified for ages, but it came to life today. Anyone who might have been able to protect the Lost Lands has either run away or perished, or is busy tending the wounded. There is no time to discuss the nature of this monster, or where it came from. You will learn in time. But for now, please go to Mount Bashar. Fiora will show you where the petrified demons rest. Take a good look around that place. I want to know how that harpy managed to free itself. I'll stay here, in case it returns. One more thing. If you find any gold, do not touch it, no matter what. That gold is cursed. The entrance is blocked. One of our brothers wounded the harpy with this spear. Her blood is on the weapon.
Thank you. Thank you. My strength is coming back. Here, take this key as a symbol of my gratitude. I think...
Close. Something must have been activated up above. Suzanne! That's the Harpy's cursed coin! Don't touch it! Remember what my great-grandpa said?
Fiora, wait for me right here.
Well, what have you learned? What? You found Lepra Khan's tomb with a petrified man standing at it? This only proves my theory. If a good soul touches the cursed gold, one of the demons is released. Unfortunately, this is how the ancient curse works. The curse was not my doing, and I can't pass judgment as to why it works the way it does. This magic was created by druids who lived long before me. Suzanne, you must take the coin left by the harpy before it causes anyone else suffering. In our relic repository, you'll find some anti-magic gloves. They'll let you touch the cursed gold without any harm. Bring me the harpy's coin. Susan, did you hear that scream outside? Was it the harpy again? What? She took away my dearest Fiora? Oh, gods! Susan, please, don't leave Fiora in trouble. Set off for the floating islands. The harpy's nest is there. My old friend Breloff, the blacksmith, also lives there, on Anvil Peak. He will help you. To make him open the gates on the Great Metronome, you need to give a sign using fireworks. Unfortunately, we've run out of fireworks. By the way, our scouts have already reported that they saw three demons fleeing from the Dark Lands. I am confused, actually. Too many terrible events for one day. Let's free my granddaughter first. I expected to see Marin. Wait, you're Susan, the one and only. I never thought I'd meet you in the flesh, ha ha. My name is Breloff. Welcome to Anvil Peak. I can guess why you've come to our lands again. The Harpy, right? Yes, I recently saw her carrying more prey to her nest. If you want to get to the Harpy's lair, you need to walk the staircase between two mechanical windmills. The steps are powered by the energy generated by these windmills. I can fix those blades, but I'm running out of coal. Up here, it's a rare commodity. Go find me some coal, would you? Before my bin is completely empty. I melt gold and forge steel here, among other things. Oh, the most precious of fuels.
Susan, over here! Oh, Susan, I knew you wouldn't leave me in trouble. Don't worry, the harpy flew away, so we have time. Listen, I have an idea. When I tried to break free from the harpy's claws, I happened to tear this amulet from her chest. She didn't seem to notice the loss. Do you still have that coin we picked up at Mount Bashar? Take this amulet and bring it to Anvil Peak. Have Braloff duplicate this cursed coin. We will replace the old claw with a new one and let the harpy find it. Put it on and turn to stone again. Don't worry about me. I'll still be in the cage, so the harpy won't suspect a thing. We need a forgery, a claw made out of the cursed gold. Seeing the harpy place great-grandfather's staff into that hole in the cube.
Yes, I see. All right, I'll help you. But I'm missing one special hammer that I use to work with enchanted metals. Unfortunately, I dropped it over the edge by the arbor. I can't guarantee it, but I'm pretty certain that the hammer fell right into the hole near the Druid village. How do I know? Because that pit was actually formed many years ago by a huge boulder that got chipped off of Anvil Peak and fell there. There was no forge here then, and the boulder stood right on the place I dropped the hammer from. Start with the village. Perhaps one of the druids knows a safe route to the bottom of the pit. Thank you.
Mickey, good dog. Easy now. Sit. Hey, who are you? And how did you... Oh, I see. You found my spare key. Well, welcome to my home. My name's Sandra, and I make my living fishing. I rarely meet anyone here in the underground, except for Naga, who is now keeping me from fishing at the underground lake. What do you need? A blacksmith's hammer? I have one. One day it dropped down from above and fell right into my millstones. Now they're broken. Here, take the hammer if you need it so badly. But remember, you owe me. This is where I write my memoirs.
Thank you.
We need a forgery. Wow, it's my Blossom! Blossom, how are you? Forgive me for losing you. Say thank you to Susan for rescuing you. Listen, the harpy came back several times here while you were away. What about the amulet? Did the blacksmith copy it? No? Hurry up or we may not have another chance. Here, this is a tool Breloff made. Take it. I found it here in the cage. Perhaps it will help. We need a forgery, a claw made out of the cursed gold.
Thank you. Hey, you, look over here.
My great-grandfather's staff out of this metal thing. It has no locks or doors, so I can't even imagine how to open it. The staff if you're to blow up the cube from the inside. It's so powerful that it can withstand anything.
I think we should get out of here.
It's going to blow!
Susan, thank God you've saved my Fiora again. Thank you. Oh, I see you also found my staff. Believe me, it will come in handy. So, we've won the battle, but not the war. You have to learn where the other demons are hiding and discover how to neutralize them. I think you'll need the rest of the golden items, so you'll need to collect them. Meanwhile, I have to deal with another important issue. How to get rid of the curse once and for all, so the demons never rise again. I need the ancient book of spells for that. Legend has it that the book is hidden in the depths of the Castle of Madness. You should talk to someone who knows the underground well. Please, take this thing. It should help you in finding the castle.
Thank you.
that took the artifact we needed to cross to the other side. I think this is an old clutch of dragon eggs. Great-grandfather told me they can be found...
Well, how about the hammer? Did it come in handy? You killed the harpy? Wow. With the hammer? Whoa. What's that? You're looking for the Castle of Madness? Yeah, I know where it is. Just beyond the underground lake. But Naga lives in the lake. And she won't let you go to the other side. However, you might be able to catch her in a net. If only someone could put a spell on this net to neutralize Naga completely. I'll make a net. And you think about some magic. I'll need a lot of horsehair and corkwood bark. I heard that there's such a tree in the Hanging Garden on the floating islands. Take this. You might need it. I found it near the hut today. Great! I understand you're planning to defeat Naga with the cursed gold. Well, the net surely should be made out of that gold, too. Please brew up some fish glue while I'm making the net. You'll cover the net in glue and roll it in the golden powder. Find a way to grind up the gold. By the way, don't forget to check the trap I set in the hold of the sunken ship at the underground lake. Maybe it caught a fish. But first, take this part from the ladder standing near the hut. I think you'll understand what to do with it. And one more thing, I'd like you to fix my millstones for my service. The net is ready. Good luck to you.
Susan, I'm very sorry about not being here when you needed me, but I hope that my tips helped you. What now? How embarrassing that someone is out of Millstone and it's my fault. I'll fix it for sure, but it will take some time. Susan, listen, do me a favor. I know that a chainmail fish lives somewhere in the lake of Mount Bashar. It's a metallic but living creature with armored scales. Get this fish for me and I will owe you. Here, take this. I think it'll come in handy.
millstone could be used to grind. Artifact we need to cross the lake. Let's climb up the ship's deck to take a look at the lake from there. We may spot. Look, I think I see it.
Thank you.
I'm sure this is the Castle of Madness. I can walk on the ceiling here! What is this?
Come closer, child. I want to get a good look at you. Ah, youth. I was your age when I was locked in this safe. Oh, yes, I forgot to introduce myself. I am Ugit, the goldsmith. Looking for the spell book? If it is here in the castle, the only suitable place is the great library. You will find the key in the lair of the Minotaur. Sometimes it leaves its lair and comes here to pick up new goods. You can summon the Minotaur using the horn. The problem is that the bellows that blow air into the horn are old and leaky. We need new ones, otherwise we won't succeed.
Wait, we can give Ugit the Minotaur amulet!
You will make another item out of it and give it to the Minotaur. The monster will pick it up without suspecting any tricks and turn into stone!
Great idea! You fix the horn, and I'll take care of the item for the Minotaur. But I'll need a pearl, and you'll have to help me sort the diamonds out of this pile of grain. Thank you.
I'm making something.
You need my bellows? Well, you can have them, considering the importance of the matter. But how will I light the fire in my furnace? All right, I'll give you the bellows, but get a good piece of leather and new dark goggles for me. My old goggles are scratched and cracked. This snow will make me blind without them. Here's a tool that will come in handy.
Thank you.
petals in the pattern indicate certain numbers. What if this is a code?
Wonderful. The item is almost ready. I made a nose ring, like the ones bulls wear. I think the Minotaur will be interested in this little thing. I'll put the finishing touches on it, and you can sound the horn. Then, go right to the lair of the Minotaur. But be careful. Don't let the beast catch you. Suzanne, I almost forgot. When you get to the library, please look for my father's notes. They're so dear to me.
Here, this key opens the lock on the bellows.
I need new bellows. I need new bellows.
What's causing the horn to sound dull? Let's try again.
Thank you.
I think this is where the Minotaur puts his very favorite items from Eugen.
Thank you. Oh, thank you. These manuscripts hold the knowledge my father didn't manage to pass on to me before he died. My father was the keeper of the great library. According to his records, the Mad Book of Spells is kept in a cache behind the bookshelves. He writes that the secret of the cache is in the way the books are numbered on the shelf. Some numbers are missing, and they comprise the code which opens the cache.
Susan, if there are books missing from the shelf, they've definitely been hidden by the Minotaur. If our plan with the cursed gold worked, the Minotaur has already been neutralized. You should go and check. What? The Minotaur wasn't petrified? I guess he dropped the new batch of golden items with the rest of them and didn't even notice the ring. I'm sure the bull ring is here somewhere. Maybe we should toss in...
You have to find...
Thank you.
I can't believe my eyes. The Mad Book of Spells. Let's have a look. Where's that formula? Ah, here it is. The Elixir of Animation. Susan, you need to return the cursed chest to the arena and put all the scattered gold into it. To do so, you will reanimate Leprok Khan himself. I suspect he stashed some gold here in our world when he carried the chest away. You'll need to get him to tell you where the cash is, and then return everything to the arena. But there's one more thing. To use the magic of reanimation, you'll have to stop the great metronome. You'll have only 1 hour for the reanimation to work. Meanwhile, I'll handle Solidus, the last of the 4 demons. See you at the arena when all the gold is gathered. Let's finish this.
we've just moved to real floating island! Let's go to the islands and chat! Hooray! The magic of the geotable in the library worked after all! We've managed to move the temple closer to Anvil Peak!
If you're here and have had to revive me, that means you know who I am and what I'm known for here in Lost Lands. Your coming was preordained, so I am not surprised to see you here. Let me guess. My brother Gorazar escaped his stone garments and is terrorizing the neighborhood. No, This is his general's work. Then all is not lost. Yes, I hid one golden item in Lost Lands. I don't remember where exactly, but you should start your quest at the Temple of Priests. Of course, when I left this world, I moved the island with the temple. Anyway, take this, and don't forget about the chest.
To the portal! Run! Don't think about us! We'll make it! Thank you for everything!